My name is Adele, and today I'm going to lead you through 30 minutes of a core workout. So today's focus is going to be, we're going to activate the gluteal complex and we're going to strengthen it. And then the next set, we're going to work on some anti-rotational core exercises. Okay? So let's get on the floor and start activating those glutes. And I forgot my timer. This is going to be really... You know what? I'm gonna go get it. Man, I thought I was all ready today. Yes. Here I go. Oh boy. Let's get started. Oh, hi. Welcome. Welcome. We just are getting started.
How did you say I'm late?
Oh, you know what? That's good because I totally forgot everything. I forgot something. So I have to, how do I get, uh-oh. Oh no, this is not a good thing. Okay, Dwayne's not here, is he? No. So how do I get you smaller? You're like being shown up on the screen. There we go. Okay, so... Mute, pin. There we go. Okay. There. So now we're ready to go. So you aren't going to be recorded, you. Okay? Let's get started. Take two. Take two! Okay, welcome to Core Blast. My name's Adele. We're going to activate those glutes today with some exercises, and then we are going to strengthen those glutes. So you'll need today is some weights. If you got dumbbells, that's awesome. If not, a weighted object. Resistance band. Now, all levels will need a stool, coffee, like some, like a couch or something that's upper, a stair. Like if you can take it to the stairs, that's another good option you have there if you don't have it. So that's what we're going to do today. But let's get on the floor for some mobility work and waken up those glute muscles, okay? So come on down. Got my timer going, forgot that one. So you're going to bring your hips, your feet together. You're gonna come on down and we're gonna do the frog bridge. We're gonna do eight of them. So your forearms are gonna be on the ground. So you're gonna push your hips up and down. We're just gonna do eight, right? You're gonna squeeze the glutes. That's what you should be focusing on the top of the move. Your hands can be wider. You might feel your forearms pushing into the floor, but we are just activating these glutes up. You got three to go. Squeeze those glutes. One more. Good. Now let's go on all fours. And so this one I like to call the half bicycle. We got a lot. We're gonna waken up the glute knee back here. So you're gonna come on all four, wrists under your shoulders, lift the chest brace. So you're going to kick back, and then you're going to come over for, what we're doing that one next. Those are called hip circles. This isn't the one. We are just going to bicycle, right? So you're going to bring the hip in, back, and out. In, back, and out. We're just going to do eight of these. Wow. It's a good day today. We're going to have a good day. You hear some snap, crackle, popping in there? These are just little hip circles. You've done these before. Okay, now let's do the other side. Hip circles, in and back, in and back. Bring the knee in, out and around. So the next one, we got three more of these. We're gonna lay on our side. Okay, let's lay on the side. Let's face each other. So let's just bring everything all lining up nice. Hips are stacked. And so now this upper leg's gonna come up. And you're gonna bring it forward and back. Forward and back. Okay, make sure the hips are stable. You don't have to kick back far. Don't kick back far. So you're just waking up the glute. We're not exhausting it. We are just waking it up. Wakey, wakey, hey? Good. Next one, we're gonna bring it up and down. Right, for eight. It's not about height. Maybe touch it. The glutes should be activating. Right? How do you find it? Put your index finger on your hip bone, and then your butt, your hand, put it on your behind, and that's your glute. That's a rough idea of what's contracting back there. Good job. Now let's do some front kicks. Do them. Like you're going to kick the screen. Let's do the other side. Okay. I'm waking up. Get some heat in there. Okay. So we are going to make sure everything's lined up. Hips are stacked. Check. Front to back. Front to back. And lead with the heel. Maybe tip the toe down a bit so that TFL doesn't take over. Sometimes it likes to take over for the glute, right? Okay, so your index finger, hip bone. Okay, let's do some sideline leg raises. One, two. Remember, lead with the heel. Down. Ooh, when you internally rotate that. You see what's going on there? Okay. Two more. Now front kicks. Good work. Okay, let's do the hip circles this time. We're gonna just do a little quick fire hydrant. And so you're gonna kick back again. You've done that. Now you're gonna bring the knee up. Make sure that the ankle is lower than your knee. Then you're gonna bring it in to your elbow and then kick back again, okay? So it's hydrant, elbow, kick back. Hydrant, elbow, kick back. Okay, when I say hydrant, it's like the fire hydrant we did last time. Okay, one more, kick back, fire hydrant. It's not about height, it's activating. It's not about fatigue, it's about waking it up. Let's do the other side. Lift chest, brace the belly, kick back. Hydrant, elbow, and back. Okay, hydrant. So this is the one where I have trouble. I don't know about you. Into the great world. One more. Good work. So our first exercise, these glutes are nice and raw, ready to go. So let's do the single leg hip bridge. This one's a little bit different. I've added something in it just to make sure that you're getting it all fired up. So let me show you first. So you're going to come down on your backs. You're going to flex this foot. Now the hand that's out opposite, you're going to push as you bring it up. Now, feel that firing up? Now you want to make sure that that lower back's pressed. You're posteriorly tilting that hip, right? A little bit, you got the pressure. Squeeze the glutes, rise and push. Okay, so we're gonna do singles. And then the next exercise, you'll need your resistance band for the clam, and then we got a folding table. Let's get started. 45 seconds of this. Now you don't have to worry. We got 45 seconds. You're gonna push, like you're pushing this way, hand pushing this way, trying to get some height, squeezing the glutes tight, and then bring it down. Let's do that again. Drive the heel into ground. Come on. And down. You don't want to arch that back, because if you're posterior tilting your hips, squeeze the glutes, and then squeeze and rise. You might feel it too in the quad. Feel that too? I feel it a lot in the glute. The other side. And this hand. Over here. We're gonna go in 5 seconds. Okay? So make sure the heel is close. Okay, drive the heel into ground, squeeze the glutes, and rise. So this is my less dominant side. I'm sure you figured that out with your body. of how it's responding to different exercises. Make sure the glute's squeezed. Yeah, I'm feeling it, aren't you? Now remember, 45 seconds is a long time if you are first time. You're gonna make it work for you. Take the break and then come and join. Get one good one. It's way better than a whole bunch of mediocres. So let's get your resistance band. It's gonna be a side plank with a clamshell. So you want your band just above. Oh, let it bark off, right? Fold the legs. You're gonna lift off and then open. Right, and down. Lift up, open, and down. Lift up, open, and down. You have the option to put your hand up here. If you wanna use that dumbbell, you can use that too. The thing is, you don't wanna lean. No, you want it stacked. Now, if you are bad for that, maybe try putting his hand forward, right? Don't put your weight on it. Yeah, you're feeling it both sides. Let's do the other side. Sometimes we need to adjust our body to make sure we're working the right muscle. Ankle lined up, check. Get ready to go, okay? So let's bring it up and open. I'm gonna come forward a little bit. That really ensures that I got a guaranteed stacking there. Squeeze. You're going to squeeze this glute knee. Bring the knee up. Right? Okay, you're not going to let. Maybe adjust how much the bend you got going on. Go a little different. Not about height, it's about activity. Building tabletop. Oh, this is a good one, you'll love it. Okay, so let's fingers point forward. Heels down. You're gonna squeeze those glutes, lift the chest, brace the core. In your t-shirt. And then you're gonna drive your heel into the ground, squeeze the glutes, and then bring it up. Tuck in the chin, hold, and then do it again. Now, with the resistance band, you can feel, maybe add a clam. You know what, I'm not doing that today, but you know, you might be there, ready for that. The part about the core blast, that you have, you can take whatever regressions, progressions, that you want, in the comfort of your space. No judgment there, is there? Squeeze those glutes. Hold it. Let's hold it. Hold it. Oh, nice. Let's do that single leg hip bridge again. Oh, you're going to lose that. Okay. Hip bridge. Bring it here close. Left hand up. Left, right. That's right hand. Left leg. Squeeze. Glutes and up. And then down. Okay. Now, if it's too much pushing, don't push, just have the hand here hanging out, right? It's been too long. Now, here's something to try. Bring the knee a bit closer, hand on the knee, push up. Where do you feel it now? Huh? Bring the knee back, squeeze. Now, where do you feel it? Maybe it's the same. You're just learning your body. Because then if you go somewhere to a medical professional, you can accurately tell them what's going on. Right? With that awareness. Okay, we're gonna do the other side. I'm excited about my holding table. Okay, so you're gonna take left hand over to the right. This is the one this is the side I really don't like to work. How about you? You get, squeeze the glutes a little more. to get some height. Maybe hold it for two counts and bring it down slow. And get it up quick and then slow it down. Oh. So when you play with the tempo too, you can really see what works for you. Because it feels so good, doesn't it? Oh. I hear the buzzer. I'm glad that's over. Okay, so it's wonderful to do it with you today. Get your band on. Check my thing. Side plank position. Let's go. Up. Now if you want the weight, you can lift it up, down, open. You got lots going on here. This is a progression you can take. That's what you'd like to do. Now you could add some transverse into it. So have your weight down, lift up, and then come up, and then thread it through and down. But you know what? What works for you today? Good. Good news, there's no triple pulses today. You don't have to worry about that stuff. Okay? Now, because I did three on that one side, I gotta do the same with the weight. So bring it up and down. Oh, I forgot to open. Flam, gotta go get that pearl, right? So try this. Try pushing this arm into your mat. Think about that. Remember, fingers tips can be forward. Really ensure that this is stacked, because if it's stacked, you're gonna feel it. Good work. Hold the table. Yes. Go this way. So you're gonna have fingers pointing toward your heels. Lift the chest. Brace the core, squeeze the butt, bring it up and down. Okay? Nice and controlled. You can hold it here. Okay? Now, a little progression you can make. You can straighten one leg, bring it in. Straighten the other. A little different, isn't it? Or you can do a nice big lift. Bring it up. Bring those hips up. That's a big challenge. So you're only going to take it where it's going to go. And you know what? When you feel that activation. When you start feeling the proper muscles activating, then go to the next stage. Okay, we are gonna need our stool. Your stool, your ottoman, your chair, your steps, whatever you got around you. Because we're gonna learn to plank on our toes. We're gonna do that, because then you're gonna feel the right activation. Your shoulders aren't gonna take over. It's a little different. It's a little different, you're gonna like it. So let's work on our base in the back. So 45 seconds on, 15 seconds off. So with the plank, it can be on your forearms. Now, your base here. Easier when those heels are wide apart. A little bit harder when you bring them close. So now you're gonna close, you're gonna hold it here. And you're gonna squeeze. Squeeze the heck out of those armpits. Squeeze those glutes together. Great. No, you need a break. Come on down. Reset. Come on up. We're going to teach those muscles some endurance, right? You might feel your obliques squeezing together from the sides, huh? make sure that butt's in line with the shoulder, please. S'il vous plaît. Need the break. Come down. Oh, we're gonna have a break now. Okay, the next one is our stool bird dog. You're gonna need to be on your hands on this one. You got wrist issues. Get your dumbbells, right? So you're gonna come in the plank position, and now you're gonna bring that opposite hand to opposite foot out. Now, if you're not there today, which I might not be, this is my third workout today, you're gonna be maybe just 1 foot out and in. But feel that activation. Here's option one. You could do option one. Lead with the heel. Maybe internally rotate that toe. Bring that toe towards the center of the body, feel more of the glute, correct? Okay? Now, if you gotta do opposite hand to opposite foot, oh boy, you gotta really brace. Widen your base if you have to. Good work. Now, the next one is our plank with the rope. Now, this is where the progression, you have the plates. Now, I'm gonna show you how to do it without or plates. These are dumbbells. Okay, so let's get in our plank position on our hands. Now, here's how you do the rope. So you're going to bring one hand in, elbow close, and then bring it down. So notice what happens when that hand leaves your ottoman or leaves your stool. What's going on? You feel that midsection nice and tight, don't you? Now, you want to add the weight? You can add the weight. You're going to hold it up high. Save me from my pain. Might be shaking, huh? Take a break. It's fine. Next one. Static bear. Oh, I love static bear. Now, the progression to this one is moving. So once you get the right activation, you can start exploring your forest. Okay, so let's get started. So you're gonna tuck the toe under, lift, brace in the middle. Okay, now you're gonna hover those knees off the ground. It's important that those knees are over top or underneath your hips. Draw those elbows in. You feel that? Need a break? Come down, get set up again. Brace everything, tuck the toe, now lift off. Oh. Now the hard part about this one is the movement. So if you are ready to move, you can come around, but you're gonna make sure those hips are nice and steady. Oh, I'm gone, right? So you're gonna make sure you're not, we're working the anti-rotational moves just to make sure everything stabilizes. So alternating knee hug. So this one, you're gonna come on your back. Use your hands to help bring you down. So you're gonna try not to let the foot touch the ground. So you're gonna hug your knee like it's hovering and then bring it in. Now the setup, if you need to, posture and tilt, brace the core. Bring the knee in, extend the leg, opposite. There you go, hug yourself a hug. Give yourself a hug. So you're keeping it nice and tight down here, hey? Yeah. That back should not arch. I can't stick my fingers underneath there. Can you? Squeeze. Bring it up. Wow. You ready for one more? Let's do one more. Yeah. Okay. Plank off the stool. Remember, forearms or hands. You can do this. You can also do these off the wall. Tuck the toe in, lift off. Good work. Now, you need more base, wider base. Make sure that those hips don't sink. You could hurt your back, right? You wanna make sure everything's nice and level. Or bring it in, right? Now, if you're ready for another progression, you can do the jacks. Right, but you really want to fight that these hips stay stable. This is the best exercise ever. Now, if you find the stool a little bit too much, try a bed. Try your bed at home. It's a little higher. That's too much. Try the wall. We all can do this. We just progress slowly. Slowly. Okay, let's do our bird dog. We're not. You could use the weights if you're looking for more. I'm not going to do that today. So let's get up to that plank position. Remember, option one. You're going to watch that heel does not go higher than the hip. Put that weight nice and forward, wrists underneath the shoulder. Now, you're going to try to keep stable. Bringing the opposite hand. Now, if you want the next progression, same arm and same foot. I'm not there today. But it's kind of fun to try, isn't it? There you go. Got to do the other side, right? That's tough. But you progress. Okay, let's do the plank with the row. You can have your weights or no weights on the stool. Now you're looking for more. You can come on the floor, right? You're gonna bring it up and down. Now you don't want those hips to rock. It's not about speed. It's about being nice and slow. Now if you need to be on the stool, you got some options, right? I'm here to give you some ideas. So when you tune in and do this workout again, which I know some people do, you're going to choose the one that works for you. Okay? Do you feel it in the shoulder? It's the hands. Good work. Nice job. Bear crawl. You're gonna move or you're gonna be static. You decide. You wanna explore the forest, right? Tuck the toe under, lift the chest. Now hover those knees, you can hold it. Now, bring those shoulder blades back and down. Brace. You get those knees a little bit lower. Okay, reset if you have to. You know what, when you reset in between, it actually builds endurance. It actually activates the core upper muscles. And bring it down. If you feel the glutes kicking in, we got them all woken up. They should be getting you nice and strong. Keep it up. You can move. Same hand, same foot. That's a challenge. Right? Good job. Good job. Alternating knee hug. And then we're into our cool down. We're gonna stretch nice and quick today. You could stay online, have coffee time with me. Bring the knee in. Okay. Bring it in. Now, you're gonna try to hover. Maybe try to kick it high. Right? Make sure that lower back stays on the floor, please. And then when you feel the right muscles activating, like those glutes, right? You can bring a little lower. You need a break. Try the toe tap. Probably don't feel anything there, do you? Huh? So you're feeling your core. Come close and out. Each side, right? Hip flexors are involved, everything. That is awesome work today. So let's do a couple big breaths in. We're gonna learn how to breathe. So you can kneel. I need a pillow, right? So come on your knees, feet wider. Okay, hands on your ribs. Okay, see them there? There we go. So as you breathe that deep breath in, feel what happens to your hands and exhale. Do it again. Nice job. So we can do that other kind of breath we did last time. You can breathe in, hold it, and then breathe even more. So breathe in, hold, a little more, and exhale. Everything's gone, right? Compression. Breathe in, hold a little more, and then exhale. Good work. So we'll do one quick glute stretch, because that was our theme today, wasn't it? So you're just gonna do the nice glute stretch. Everybody loves this glute stretch. You're gonna cross over, flexing the foot right above the knee. You're gonna grab either behind the knee. If you're not quite there, you're gonna come up on your forearms, bring them nice and close in. I'm gonna do some flossing of the nerve. A good thing to do. But feel the stretch in your glutes. Pull it in. Nice job. Relax in the stretch. Switch legs. Right, we're just gonna quickly hold this one. I encourage you to stretch a little longer after this class. Maybe a 10-day polytech yoga class, right? They're nice, they're fun, right? And that is your core blast today. Thank you so much for joining me. Have a good day.